Thank you very much for being here. Merci d'être ici avec nous aujourd'hui. Je suis ici sur le territoire traditionnel des Mississauga, Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, and Huron-Wendat. I'm here on the traditional territories of the Mississauga of the Credit, the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee, and the Huron-Wendat. Wonderful to see some greens here today as well, and thank you to my husband and my son for coming as well. Alors, d'abord en français, je voulais dire que après les derniers quelques jours,
après avoir reçu le mail qui annonçait le déclenchement de la leadership review directly. I considered whether I had the strength to continue in this role. Did I have the strength to continue to follow or take on the attacks, the conflict? Would there be place for a contribution from me? And finally, the decision was that no, there wasn't. So I decided that I want to come and get in contact with the Federal Council to start the process of my withdrawal and maybe find a leader before a leadership race.
You know, we had a long election, not a long election, but we just finished the election. And the day of the election and the couple of days after the election, you know, there were just a couple of things that happened that really caused me to think about what I wanted next. On the day of the election itself in the morning, the only email that I received from our council, from the president of our council, was an email calling for an emergency meeting to launch a leadership review. And then on Saturday night, only a few days after the election, there was an announcement sent to all of the members, including myself, that a leadership review had been launched. And when I received those two things, at the time that I received them, I just asked myself whether this is something that I wanted to continue, whether I was willing to continue to put up with the attacks I knew would be coming, whether to continue to have to fight and struggle just to fulfill my democratically elected role as leader of this party, and I just don't have the heart for it. The election was very difficult for those who have been following. They will know that, you know, and it doesn't take a rocket scientist to know that when you head into an election without funding for your campaign, when you head into an election without the staff to staff your campaign, when you head into an election without a national campaign manager, when you head into an election being, again, under the threat of a court process from your party, it's going to be very hard to convince people to vote for your party. And so there are those who will ask, why did I choose to go ahead in any case? And I can tell you that it was a tremendous struggle to decide to continue. I knew that we were likely not going to do well. And I knew that as the leader, even without those tools that I needed, the first person that the public would look at would be me. But I chose to continue because of some of the people that are standing here today. The extraordinary members of the Green Party who didn't do anything to deserve this and deserve to have the opportunity for a good election. The candidates, the candidates and the volunteers, again, who deserve to have a leader going into the election and deserve to at least have an opportunity to be represented. Many of those candidates were candidates that I had recruited through the Time to Run program. It was the most diverse slate of candidates that we had, even though it wasn't a full slate. And so I felt that responsibility. I also felt a responsibility you know, to show that someone like me could get as far as I could, and that I could draw on wells of strength, much of it coming from, again, the people who are here today and others, to at least get across that finish line. Because when I talked in the debate about that, crawling over that glass, what people need to realize is that when I was elected and put in this role, I was breaking a glass ceiling. What I didn't realize at the time is that I was breaking a glass ceiling that was going to fall on my head and leave a lot of shards of glass that I was going to have to crawl over, you know, throughout my time as a leader. And when I arrived at that debate stage, I had crawled over that glass. I was spitting up blood, but I was determined to be there. I was determined to be there so that the next time someone like me thinks of running and wonders whether it's possible to be on that stage, they will know that it is possible to do that. And so those are the reasons that I continued. Those are the reasons that I don't have any regrets about having gone through the election. But I do have to recognize that it is quite clear to me that I am not going to have the opportunity to lead. I have not been given that opportunity, and I will not be given that opportunity. I just will not spend any more time focused on political games as opposed to public policy, which is what I entered politics for in the first place, particularly at a time when it is so needed. We have a climate crisis that we have got to address collectively. We have people who are counting on us to ensure that we have more progressive policies that leave them better protected. And none of those things can be accomplished if the focus is solely on these kind of internal political issues. And so I will definitely find other ways to serve. This was always about service, and I have been outside of politics for most of my life, and so I know that there are other ways to serve. And for all of those people who are disappointed, for all of the supporters who wrote and asked me to please continue, please know that this was not easy. It has been extremely painful. It has been the worst period in my life in many respects, but I am not alone, and you are not alone. We need to see the quest towards equity and justice as a relay race as opposed to a one-person race. And so someone like me, we take the baton and we take it as far as we can. And when our strength fails us, what we are counting on is that there is someone else who can take that baton from us and move us a little bit further down the line so that we can ultimately cross that finish line. And I promise you that we will cross that finish line. Alors, à tous les supporters, à tous les personnes
so to all supporters and all people who encourage me to continue, I'm saying that I'm going to continue to serve. It was always about service for me. It was always about participating in the creation of policies, progressive policies. It was always about participating in the fight against climate change, and it was always about creating a more diverse and inclusive culture in our political culture, and I'm going to continue to participate in all of these efforts. But I have to say that it's enough, and I don't have the strength to continue and suffer the attacks from inside the party, from advisors, from ex-leaders in our party, and also our council. It's not the reason why I chose to get into politics, and it's the moment to now go in a different direction.
And so for those Green Party members, and there are many, because I have met some of the very best people in my life through the Green Party, I want to say that there is a struggle that is going on for the soul of the party. For those of you that want to see the Green Party fulfill its promise and its values, then there is work to do. And for those Green Party members who have taken great pleasure in attacking me, in calling for assaults against me, in calling for organization against me, in suggesting that I'm part of a conspiracy against the party, you may take small comfort in this for a moment, but please know that there are many more people like me than there are you, and you will not succeed in the end. You will not succeed in the end. And I will look to those other people to take up the baton and to move the party in the direction that I still believe that it can go in. I want to thank my husband very much and my son very much and my family very, very much for sticking with me through this. It has been hard on all of us for a very long time, and no one can do this alone. And I want to send all my love to all the people who are standing behind the cameras and those in other parts of the country who have made it possible for me to last as long as I have. I think that's it. There certainly will be more in the days to come, but I wanted to provide this clarity, particularly in light of the leadership review that was called for yesterday, so that we can begin to move toward the next stage, and certainly so that I can also begin to move towards the next stage. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much.